back to my channel. It's Amber, your favorite notary from Texas, and I'm here to give you a video in my car because we are going to be on the move today. Channel, welcome. I talk about all things notary and entrepreneurship, so hopefully after this video, if you like what you see and you found it helpful, you'll hit that subscribe button. All right, so today is a pretty busy day, and I just wanted to bring you along for the ride just so that you can kind of see how my schedule would go today. So this morning, I've already dropped off my two kids at school, and I'm headed to my first appointment at 9 o'clock. So Bank of America has been giving me so many HELOC orders. Let me correct myself. Mortgage Connect has been sending me a lot of orders for HELOCs for Bank of America. I was thinking about that, and I was like, that's not exactly accurate. So Mortgage Connect of Texas, or Mortgage Connect, I'm sorry, they are the ones that are sending me HELOC, or home equity lines of credit. And so they either call me for these orders, or they just send them directly to my phone or through text, and I snatch them up really quick. The reason why I love these HELOC orders, especially from Bank of America, is because the page size is minimal. It's about 80 pages, which includes the client copies. So in the 80 pages, it's the client copy and the bank copy. It takes place at Bank of America, so I don't have to rent a title office, which I typically do for cash outs. If I had to, that would be fine, but I just love going to Bank of America and having it all set up already for me. So I have that appointment at 9, and then I've got to rush over to either my office or Starbucks to do a remote closing with Amrock. So the Amrock closing is at 10 o'clock, and so that's why it's going to be, you know, I'm going to be rushing. I don't think I'm going to be rushing, but I'm going to be rushing. We'll see. But anyways, these HELOCs do not take that long. So those are the only two closings I have scheduled for today. So I'm about to pull up to Bank of America and show you the setup. It's really simple. The bankers there give you an office, and the buyers, or the borrowers, I'm sorry, and the signers meet me there, and I take care of them like I'm an employee of a Bank of America, and just meet me in the office. After that, I've got some one-on-one coaching sessions scheduled via Google Meets or video call that I have for my mentees set up. And that's basically like a question and answer session. Some of them are doing mock signings with me. And so they're about 45 minutes to 1 hour long. So right after that, right after these closings, I've got two of those lined up. So go ahead and stay tuned and follow me as we get this day started.
Your destination. Arrived.
So I am done with those first two appointments, and neither one of those went how I thought they would go, and that is okay, and I'm glad that happened so that I could tell you guys about it. So the 9 o'clock HELOC appointment did not start until 9:30. All right, so once they finally show up, we go ahead and get started, and then he decides to be a reader. So generally I never have had a HELOC take longer than maybe 10-15 minutes because I go over everything that they need to know up front, but he wanted to read quite a bit of his that there was a, I was looking for Starbucks, but I didn't see it, and I just went to the next door, which was Chick-fil-A, and just decided to set up there. So, yeah. All right, so I'm setting up at Chick-fil-A, and I'm about to show you the video of just me going in, setting up, and get on the call. I was on time with 1 minute to spare, and I made it. And the borrower was having technical issues. And so the first time I called tech support, it took 15 minutes to get things back online and rolling. Mind you, this has never happened at all, you know, me doing these remote closings with Rocket Mortgage. All right, so we get back on and we get to the first document, and then again, same thing. So I just was like, okay, well, let's get this done. I really wanted them to get their closing done, and I didn't want to give up the closing either. So I just was trying to work it out. It was really taking way longer than it needed to take. And so at that point, I just decided to double task and just do some other things while tech was on the line trying to get their computer working. So I scanned in my 9 o'clock appointments into the lender, responded to a few emails. I did a couple responses on my social media and things like that. And then finally at 11 o'clock, so that's 1 hour later, that's when everything was finally back up. So the borrower, they just ended up having really bad connection, not good internet, and their laptop was, I don't know, just not working. So they got themselves a new laptop to use, and so we got done with assigning within 10 minutes after everything was back online. And so that is where we are right now. Why I'm doing this video on the go in the car, because I'm having to drive back to my, and this was not the closest one. I drove a good 20 minutes out here just to take that HELOC signing. And so now I'm driving back because now I have my mentorship one-on-one calls that I have to do by 12:30, and I still need to drop documents off at UPS. So I just kind of wanted to narrate all of that for you guys, and I'll show you guys the video here. All right, so now that I'm home, I am looking to see where I want to set up to have my one-on-one call with one of my mentees, and I was going to go to the patio, but it was a little cold. There was a little breeze outside this morning, so I decided not to. So that's why you'll see me go out there and then eventually just set up in the living room. All right, before I sat down, I wanted to make myself a cup of lemonade. Obviously, I'm being dramatic here, but you get the point. All right, so I just opened up my computer, taking a look at my schedule, and just kind of getting prepared and ready for my first appointment with my mentee. There I am. All right, and before every one-on-one appointment, I send a few questions to the person to gauge what it is that they need from me during the one-on-one session. So this is just me kind of getting some information ready to share with her, so that I can be more organized and be better prepared to help her with what she needs. In a minute, you will see where, and you'll hear
where she will come on and the sessions last up to 45 minutes.
So I'm done with both of my one-on-one mentorship appointments, and now I am headed. All right, so I'm back in the car for a last-minute appointment that I got while I was in the middle of my one-on-one appointment. So I'm going to go ahead and go in here. It's just the power of attorney. So what happened was they called me while I was on the one-on-one, and I just sent them the link while I was in the meeting. Sent them a text message with a link to my scheduling platform where they just went ahead and scheduled for today's appointment. And so here I am, and I will see you guys when I get back. So we are done with that power of attorney. I only needed to notarize and witness one signature. And so now I'm headed to UPS to drop off this morning's HELOC that was started my day. Obviously, I just didn't have time. I usually drop right after appointments, but I just didn't have time because, I mean, they were late. Then I had technical difficulties with the remote closing, and then I had to come back home and get ready for my one-on-one calls. So now I have time to drop them off. It is 3:00 right now. So that kind of gives you a little bit of a time frame of how my day went. Started at 9, ending at 3. And so, yeah, that's it. I'm just going to head up inside of UPS, scan this in, get my receipt, and head home so that I can pick up my babies from school. Hopefully you guys learned something from my video. Hopefully you learned something from this video today and you could take something from this to help you in your business. If you liked what you saw and it was helpful, please like and subscribe and share. Leave me a question or comment down below and I would love to respond. You guys have a great evening, weekend, whatever day this is for you. Just have a great day. Make it good. Stay positive. See you next time.